Security was heightened at National Environment Management Authority NEMA offices in Kampala today. This was after a group of alleged wetland encroachers marched to NEMA offices, who said they wanted to engage in talks with NEMA officials because they believed they were being illegally evicted by NEMA. Led by their lawyer, Edias Lukwago, the wetland occupants later engaged with NEMA ED Dr. Balirega Kankwasa. During the interface, the NEMA director, Balirega Kankwasa, assured the protesters that NEMA officials shall listen to them on case-by-case basis during their field operations.
Akachiko akasarawo kaja kukora okusarawo nga kugendera ku gumba eryo. Wetusanga nga ensonga teziri mu gumba, tulina okugenda mu maaso n'entegeka nga bw'ebadde.
He added that people who received land titles before the year 1995 shall not be evicted. Edias Lukwago, the Lord Mayor, as the residents remain calm after NEMA agreed to address their concerns.
Abakola petition muzituwe muzirete. Abe nansa na buli omu abakola petition muzirete. Bobate wakola petition, process eba yeyongedde yo, tusobola kutasiriza mu kachiko ka parliament akakosa sakani, akasegona.
NEMA issued restoration orders by the National Environment Act 2019 to all encroachers to immediately stop all activities that degrade the wetland and vacate the wetland with immediate effect. Kampala Capital City Authority Executive Director Dorothy Kisaka has revealed that the 114 billion shillings that was allocated by KCCA in the last financial year shall be dedicated to the development of the city. Kisaka made the revelation in a press conference at City Hall this morning. Kisaka said that as an authority, they've achieved the desired objectives. She outlined the achievements of KCCA, which include the construction of Kampala flyovers, street lighting, and construction of drainage channels, among others.
Under roads and drainages, we have made significant progress in infrastructure development. During the NAM summit in January this year, we refurbished 35 kilometers, covering 10 roads in Makindye Division.
She revealed that the authority is going to launch a facility which is going to be used for monitoring city traffic.
Under technology advancement, we have established a landmark achievement which we call the Kampala Traffic Control Center in the center of Kampala here at City Hall. The building is completed and ready for installation of the equipment and to serve as the base for traffic control in the city.
During the same forum, Kisaka unveiled the intended undertakings for this financial year, among which is keeping the city clean and constructing roads. She highlighted challenges encountered by KCCA, which include underfunding and slow pest contractors, among others. Joe Biden has caught COVID-19 and cancelled a speaking engagement at the last minute before he was due to address a conference in Las Vegas on Wednesday afternoon, the White House has confirmed. The U.S. president had developed symptoms and just before he was going to address the UNDOS U.S. annual conference in Nevada, after a long delay, the organization's president and chief executive, Janet Mugi, told those that gathered he would not be taking the podium. Shortly afterward, the White House press secretary announced the positive test for the 81-year-old Democrat Biden, who had spent two nights in Vegas on the campaign trail. Biden tested positive for COVID-19 while visiting Las Vegas yesterday and is self-isolating after experiencing mild symptoms, the White House said. Minutes after the announcement, the president's motorcade was on the move to Las Vegas airport after taping a radio interview in the city. As he boarded Air Force One to depart Las Vegas for Delaware, Biden told reporters that he felt good as he climbed the stairs slowly, holding the railing tightly and pausing a few steps in and again towards the plane entrance. The illness comes at a crucial time for Biden, who has been losing ground in battleground states against Republican Donald Trump, who is headlining a triumphant convention this week after he survived an assassination attempt on Saturday. The White House said Biden planned to spend a long weekend at his Delaware beach house. It was unclear how long the sickness would keep him from the campaign trail.